Hey, I'm Josh Trank.
And I am Simon Kinberg.
And this is our breakdown of the Fantastic Four trailer.
So stick around, because we're giving you an exclusive inside look.
How did we get this far? Human beings have an immeasurable desire to discover, to invent, to build.
I'm a really big fan of Brian Hitch and his artwork and everything he's done. And the big thing that really inspired me from his work in the Ultimates was seeing Reed in a garage. Mm-hmm. I absolutely wanted to tell the story of a young Reed Richards.
Yeah, and I think because we wanted to tell a generational story, I mean, you did it in Chronicle, and we do it in this movie of it being about the next generation. That's one of the reasons that we looked at the Ultimates as, you know, part of the inspiration for the movie, because those are their younger Fantastic Four.
You remember I told you I talked to Stan Lee mm-hmm. about this, and I kind of gave him a very, like, not so much a pitch, but I just told him why I wanted to do the Fantastic Four. And he just genuinely loved the idea that somebody would be taking the Fantastic Four seriously like that and putting them into a modern space, mm-hmm. which was really cool to just kind of hear Stanley, you know, co-sign on that.
Our future depends on us furthering these ideas. A responsibility that rests on the shoulders of generations to come.
Miles Teller as Reed Richards, Kate Mara as Sue Storm, Michael B. Jordan as Johnny Storm, and Jamie Bell as Ben Grimm. I mean, I don't think we could possibly find four better actors to portray these characters in this version of the story.
Yeah, and I think because we wanted it to be grounded and dramatic, we went for the four best dramatic actors.
But with every new discovery,
when Jack and Stan created the Fantastic Four in the 60s, we were on the brink of science really physically changing the world.
Yeah, no, I think the same way that it was the next generation that sent men to the moon, it's now the next generation that's like creating the internet.
Yeah,
it's and
like, yeah.
The new frontier. And I remember from the beginning with this movie, you wanted to explore what that new frontier would look like and do a superhero movie that was as grounded in science and reality.
I really wanted to see science and science fiction, which I think we kind of rarely see.
There is risk. There is sacrifice.
Yeah, that will be probably the frame that is frozen and screen captured and emailed the most of anything in the teaser, I would say.
It only made sense to use mocap technology to bring Ben Grimm to life and being able to register all of the details of expression and emotion through the motion capture performance, because Jamie Bell is such a terrific actor. One thing that does stay the same are the eyes. It's Jamie's eyes when he's not in mocap, and it's Jamie's eyes when he is in mocap.
And there are consequences.
Was your idea to create these suits that had a real science function to them, and that
yeah.
they would, we termed them, or you termed them, containment suits.
Yeah.
And they would help them control, contain these powers that were really new to them.
In Stanley and Jack Kirby's Fantastic Four, you have four characters that get into a rocket and go into space. They encounter cosmic rays, and that transforms them into who we know now as the Fantastic Four.
And it's one of the things that we took really seriously, and there's real science exploring it right now, is this notion of interdimensional travel.
Yep.
Be ready for what's coming.
What is coming?
The answers.
This was the first most important superhero group in the history of modern comics. And obviously there's a lot of responsibility there. The most important thing about the Fantastic Four is that this is a movie about a family.
I remember the first time I read a Fantastic Four comic, what was so remarkable about it was that it was about a group of superheroes who were this little surrogate family. And that all the dynamics that are like good and bad that are part of being in a family were playing out in a comic book, and I'd never really seen that before. There's obviously people with families in comics, plenty of them.
Or where it's like secondary.
Right, you know? Right, exactly.
But this, the core of the Fantastic Four is seeing how far a family can stretch, no pun intended, mm-hmm. to put them into the most extreme of circumstances and see how far they can be stretched and yet come back together and be stronger than ever. That's just really what the Fantastic Four is all about.